guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'll be doing a video that is long overdue, but hey, better late than never, right? So today we're going to be talking about some baby must-haves, what I think are super important as a mother, whether you're a first-time mother or not, some items that you definitely need to have for your baby or to take care of your baby. So the first item is these onesies with zippers. These are so much better than the one with snaps, because once you change your baby or you're putting your baby in there and they're fussy and they're crying, you don't have time to snap 50 buttons before you're done. They would just cry their heads off. So this just zips down, zips right back up, and it's so much easier to get them in here than to button 50 snaps. So yeah, onesies with zippers are definitely a must-have. You need to have a lot, because you know how babies get through clothes in one day, okay? The next item on the list is birth cloths. You need a lot of birth cloths. So what I use for my birth cloths, are these washcloths. I think I got them from Target. They came in a pack of 3 or 4, and I have a total of like, I don't know, 20. Yeah, you get through these very quickly, trust me. You're cleaning up vomits, drools, spit ups, and you get through this a lot, like very quickly, so you need a lot. I'll say get at least 20 on hand, whatever you decide to use for burp cloths, because I know some mothers have like the larger muslin cloths for burp cloths. Whatever it is, just make sure you have enough on hand, because you're gonna need them. The next on the list is swaddles. You definitely need swaddles. Babies, when they come right out of the womb, they are still not sure where they are, and they need to have that I'm still in the womb kind of feeling. So swaddles are so important, and the one that I love the most is this Love to Dream swaddle. Isabel loves this thing, or loved this thing, because she's outgrown it now. But this was awesome, because it stretches on both ways, and it has two zippers, one from the top and then another one from the bottom. So if your baby's in here and you need to change her in the middle of the night, you don't have to take her out of it completely. You can just unzip the bottom part, pop out her booty, and then change and put her right back in and zip it up, and she's right back to sleep. I absolutely love this, and just the stretch in it gives it give her enough room to move around without still startling her awake. You know, if your baby has really bad startling reflex, yeah, this is definitely one of my favorite swaddles. The next thing that I think is essential is the boba wrap. Now, it's mostly important if you have a tiny baby, you know, if they can't fit into the other types of carriers right away. Because for me, my Isabel is a preemie, and she's still a very tiny baby, so she couldn't fit into the other carriers that had a weight limit, you know, beginning with. So boba wrap was awesome. It was amazing. I just, once I got past the wrapping up situation, it was awesome for me. It's a lot easier to slip her in, plus she's close to my body, she can feel my body warmth. It was just awesome. It was perfect to hold her, to be able to do things around the house, and sometimes I actually loosened it a bit and nursed her while she was in there. So it was great. It was great for me. I know a lot of mothers don't like it, but it worked wonders for me. And the next thing on the list going along with the boba wrap is the Infantino carrier, or just a baby carrier in general. I use the Infantino carrier, I'll insert a picture, and it worked a lot better for us once Isabel grew up. And you know, she was a little bit more mobile, just because she was at a point where she wanted to explore and then have her hands free and look out into the world. So whenever we would go on walks, we put her in there, face her out, and she just loved looking at the trees, looking at the lamp posts and all that stuff. So a carrier is definitely important for your baby, just so when you're taking the walks, they can also have a chance to look out and kind of walk with you rather than just sit in the car seat all the time or in the stroller all the time. The next thing on my list, especially for breastfeeding mamas, is this My Breast Friend pillow, right? So this was very helpful when I was breastfeeding Isabel, especially because she was also small. I would just prop it up right here and then lay her on it, and that gave me a lot of, you know, mobility with my hand. Maybe I wanted to multitask and do something else, you know, I would have her here. Sometimes I would even like pick it up and walk around if I had to just go put something down real quick. It was definitely very helpful. Now you still have to prop your back with pillows whenever you're nursing, but this gives you that, you know, front support when you need it, rather than just holding your baby the whole time. Plus, once she outgrew this, I use it myself for my back support when I'm chilling in bed. I just use it. Yeah, it's very comfortable. Now, it might not work best for, you know, sitting your baby up like how the boppy pillow does, but still, this is really great for breastfeeding. To go along with the breastfeeding, the next thing on the next item on the list is a breastfeeding cover-up. So this is the one that I have. I think it's by Boppy, and I prefer this over the Infinity scarf looking one, just cause that one was a little too big for me, maybe just for my small frame, and it would just plop right on Isabel and it just felt like she was suffocating. So this one was definitely a lot better for me. So this nursing cover, you just loop it through right here like you would a fabric belt, and then you just slip it around your neck, make it tighter or looser once you're done, and you can look at your baby this way. I definitely loved this one because it was easier to slip it on and take it right off in public. So yeah, if you're not as comfortable as other mothers just whipping it out without a cover, you have a solution right here, and I definitely think you should get it whether you're comfortable or not. It is just great to have it and just cover up, or just, you know, feed your baby in peace without anyone trying to bother you, even though you have the right to breastfeed in public. The next thing on the list is a changing pad or a changing mat when you go outside. These are amazing. I remember it was actually a friend that recommended this to me. She was my friend Ajoa. She was like, Jennifer, in her New York accent, she said, Jennifer, you need this in your life. And she was not kidding. Like, when you go out in public to, you know, public restrooms, the changing stations are not all that great and they're not clean. You don't know what baby was there before and what they did on it. So having this, putting it down before you put your baby on the changing station is so, so helpful. And I love this particular one just because it has these flaps. And so if your baby is like moving around, you know, they don't have to touch the sides of the changing station. They can still, it can still get caught with these. So I absolutely love this. It has this pocket here, and that's where I put the diapers. And then the wipes go in here. That's where it is. So yeah, this is definitely, definitely awesome. And plus, you don't have to take your entire diaper bag into the bathroom. You just take this out of it and just go to the bathroom with it. So yeah, I definitely love this. The brand that I have is Skip Hop. I'm not promoting any brand or getting paid for this. Just wanted to mention in case you want to know which brand I use. Skip Hop, and it is awesome. I love it, love it, love it. The next thing on the list is a cooler bag. So, I mean, I feel like this is kind of like a duh, especially if you know, you're going somewhere with your baby. You're gonna have to have a cooler to put your food in there to either keep it warm or cold. But I think most people use it for cold. That's what I use it for. So this one comes with an ice pack you can freeze and put in here. Right now I have her water in here, and then one of her bottle foods. So yeah, this is very, very essential because you're gonna have to keep her food fresh and nice when you go outside so she can have good food to eat. The brand that I'm using is JJ Cole. Again, I'm not promoting any brand, just wanted to mention if you wanted to know. The next thing on my list that I feel like I recently added to my list just because it came in handy is a thermometer. You need a thermometer because babies just can, their sickness can just creep up on you. Like, it does not give you a warning, it doesn't give you anything. Next thing you know, your baby has a fever and you're like, whoa. So yeah, it comes out of nowhere. The thermometer, you need to have that on hand. Make sure your baby, you know, you catch anything soon before you go to the hospital. You don't want to wait till you go to the hospital before they tell you, oh yep, she has a fever. No, you're gonna know it first, and you know, be able to tell if you have to take her to the hospital or no. So a thermometer is definitely very, very important. So the last thing on my list is a diaper backpack. Now, I used to have the regular diaper bag, you know, the one that goes on your shoulder, and it was great like the first couple weeks or months, but then after Isabel was growing and I needed to put more things in her bag, it just got too heavy and just too crowded, and I didn't even have space sometimes for a lot of things that needed to go in there. So I saw one of my friends using the diaper backpack, and I was like, oh my gosh, like that's so genius, that's awesome. And I feel like we've all used backpack before, and we know that can fit a lot more things than purses, even though we still like to use purses in college rather than backpacks, but I digress. So yeah, we bought this backpack and it has been amazing. I mean, it has so many pockets, so much space in there. We have a space for her food, and then we have another space for her clothes and her diapers, and this one comes with insulated pocket here. You can put hot or cold. It comes with a handy dandy diaper, wipe thingy. You can just, you know, pull it out even when it's still on your back. It has this little space in here, another pocket right up top for like little things that you want to reach. So yeah, I definitely recommend that you have a diaper backpack. It's a lot easier. Plus your husband would not mind putting it on rather than having him hold a purse-like bag or whatever. They would rather prefer this one. So yeah, that's it. That's it for this video, guys. Obviously, I'm sure there's a lot more that are important to have as a mother for your baby, but these are the few that I wanted to share with you all. Let me know in the comment section below what you think is essential for your baby, or what you found helpful, and anything else you'd like to know, just ask in the comment section below. And I'll see you guys in my next video.